Hello children, welcome back to another lesson in multiplication. Last lesson we have learned about the tables, how to multiply and get the tables with all the tricks. Then we have done, let's recall what we have done, multiplication and its terms that are used in multiplication and multiplication strategies. Today we are going to learn about multiplication, but how to derive addition factors, as multiplication is repeated addition as well as multiplication facts. So we're going to derive multiplication and addition facts, and also multiplication of a single digit number, multiplication of two and three digit numbers, grouping and regrouping. Let us find out how we get the addition and multiplication facts. Here there are three groups. In each group there are two flags. So one, two in one group. In one block there are another two, and in third block there are another two. So what we derive from here are that there are three groups with two flags each. So we repeat number 2, because we are doing addition facts again and again, and what we get is 6. The number 6, what we get, 2 plus 2 plus 2 gives us 6. Now we need to multiply, because it's a multiplication fact. It is a multiplication fact. So for multiplication fact, 2 into 3. Why 2? Because there are 2 flowers in each group and there are 3 groups. 1, 2, 3. So we are going to multiply 2 into 3, and 2 into 3 gives us 6. How did we get 6 here? 2 threes are is 6, and when we add 2 plus 2 plus 2 gives us 6. So the addition facts are 2 plus 2 plus 2, while multiplication fact is 2 into 3. Now in the next picture we have 4 groups, and in each group there are 3 butterflies. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So in each group there are 3 butterflies. So since there are 4 groups, we are going to repeat number 3 4 times. That means 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. What does that give us? That gives us 3 plus 3 plus 3. Let's see how much you get. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So what did we get? We got 12. Now for multiplication facts, we will have to multiply 3. Why are we multiplying by 3? Because there are 3 butterflies in each group. And how many groups are there? There are 4. So we write the multiplication sign and we write number 4, and we get the answer as 12. Because 3 fours are is 12. Now let me do another example. For example, if I have 1, 2 in one group, I have 2 lollipops in another, can anyone tell me how many groups are there? There are 5, and each group has 2 lollipops in it. So that means what we are going to do is, for an addition fact, teacher has written AF as addition fact, we get 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2. Why has teacher added 5 times? Because there are 5 groups. And what does teacher get? Teacher gets 10. Because 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 gives you 10. Now let's derive the multiplication fact. I have written MF for multiplication sign. Now, since there are two in each group and there are five groups of each, I will multiply 2 into 5. When I multiply 2 into 5, I get 10. So now, have you followed the concept how to get an addition and multiplication facts? The same way, let us do the number line. Write the addition and multiplication facts for each of this number line. There are two number lines and we need to write the addition and multiplication facts. Here, from 0, it has taken a jump till number 3. From 3 to 6 and 6 to 9 and 9 to 12. So we know that means there are 1, 2, 3, 4 jumps. And 4 jumps of 3 numbers. So when we write the facts, we will write 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 jumps, that means for addition facts, we will take 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. And what do we get here? We get 12. So on the number line, the jumps are, we are getting it as 12. So it's similarly, here, since the jumps are 4 and the numbers taken are 3, we have to multiply for the multiplication facts. 3 into 4, and that gives us 12. In the next number line, we see the jumps are 1, from 0 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 8, and 8 to 10. That means there are 2 digits in each. So how many times are the jumps taken? 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here there's 1, 2, 3, 4 jumps. Here there are 5 jumps. So we will have to add 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And what did we get here? 10. Similarly, let us find out how many jumps we are going to get here. We have 5 groups, so we will need 2 into 5. Why did we get 5? Because the jumps are 5 and the digits taken are 2. And what did you get 2 multiplied by 5? 2 fives are 10. So on the number line, how you have done the addition facts over here and got the same number, we also have done, because we have done the similar jumps on a number line. Multiplying by 10, 20, 30, 90. Now for example, we take 3 into 10 and we get 30. And 6 into 10 gives us 60. 20 into 10 gives us 200. What have you noticed? You have noticed that when you multiply, as you have learned your properties, when you multiply any number with 1, you get the number itself. And here, when we multiply a number by 10, we simply put a 0 to the right of the number. This is to the right of the number, we put a 0. For example, 9 into 20. 9 twos are 80. So that means, or 9 into 2, 10. That's equal to 18 tens, which gives us 180. What have I done here? I have added the 0. Similarly, what is 6 multiplied by 80? Now 6 multiplied by 80 will give you 6 into 8 tens, and that gives you 6 eights is 48. What is 6 eights? 48. So we get 48 tens, which is equal to 480. How did teacher get 480? Because you have to multiply the number. I multiplied 6 with the number in the tens place. 6 eights are 48. And since we have to only add a 0 when we multiply by 10, I put a 0 and I get 480. So when we multiply a number by 10, 20, 30, 90, we multiply the number by 1, 2, 3, 9 and put a 0 to the right of the product. Please see that you put a 0 to the right of the product and not to the left. The concept should be clear that you have to put a 0 to the right. Multiply by 100, 200, 900. For example, when you multiply 3 into 100, you get 300. How? Because I have multiplied 3 by 1 and I get 3 into 1 is 3. So you get 300. Similarly, when you multiply 14 into 3, now 14 is a double digit number. 14 is a double digit number. So 14 into 3. We write the numbers vertically and multiply this. This is actually regrouping because 3 fours is 12. Alright, I multiply 3 ones into 4 ones. When I multiply 3 ones into 4 ones, I get 12, carry 1. To make you understand, I have written the 1 in blue that says 2 is carried above. 3, 1 size 3. What do I do with that 1? 3 ones are, 3 ones are 1 tens it is. So 3 ones size 3, 3 plus 1 gives us 4. What do I get? 3 plus 1 gives us 4. But I am multiplying this number 14 into 300. I am multiplying 14 into 300. What I have done is I have taken the number 14 and multiplied with the 3 digit. That is the 3 number. But I will add these 2 zeros since I get 14 multiplied by 3, I get 42. All I do is add the 2 zeros to the right of the number. I have added the 2 zeros to the right of the number and I get 4,200. It is very simple when you are multiplying with tens, hundreds, thousand. You all you have to do is multiply the numbers 1 to 9, whatever the digit that is given, and add the number of zeros. Let's do multiplication with regrouping of ones and multiplication with regrouping of tens. How do we go about it? For example, if you are given a number 15 multiplied by 5, you know that in an expanded form 15 is equal to 110 plus 3 ones. So 3 into 15, what you are supposed to do is take the number that is given, the number 3, and multiply with the 10 and the 1s. So what teacher has done is I have multiplied 3 into 110 plus multiplied 3 into 5 ones, which I get 3 tens plus 15 ones. So 3 tens plus 110. I have split it up the number 15 into 110 plus 5 ones. And I get 3 tens plus 110 gives me 4 tens plus 5 ones. The result, the answer, when I multiply 15 by 3, I get 45. This is a long method. Similarly, another method where you are multiplying with tens. Here we have done multiplication with ones. And here we are doing multiplication with tens. Expand. Let's take another example. Example 2. 21 multiplied by 3. It's a regrouping of ones. So in expanded notation, as we have done here, let's take number 21. Now this 21 is equal to 2 tens. 2 tens plus 1, 1. Now, what we have to do is take the number 3 and multiply the tens and 1s. So, we are going to do, we take the 3 and multiply this with 21 and we get 3 into 2 tens, 3 into 2 tens plus 3 into 1 ones. We have only one ones here in ones place, so we take 3 into 3 tens. Now we have 3 into 2 tens. So the answer here will be 3 twos are is 6. So we will have 6 tens. Here plus 3 ones are is 3. So we have only 3 1. What is the answer now? The answer we derive from here, or the product that we derive, is 63. How did we get 63? By splitting it and separating it in the expanded notation, by putting it in tens and ones place, we get 63. If we do it by the long method, if we take 21 and we multiply by 3, 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. Did we get our answer right? Example of multiplying 43 by 3. In the expanded notation, you have seen 43 is 4 tens plus 3 ones. 4 tens plus 3 ones. So 3 into 43. Why have I taken 3 into 43? Because we are asked to multiply 43 by 3. So when we take 3 into 43, then we split it up, we separate it and multiply 3 in 3 into 4, because 4 is in the tens place. So 3 fours are 3 into 4 tens plus 3 into 3 ones, because that is number 3 here, because it's 43. So when we multiply 3 into 4 tens, what we get is 12 tens. 12 tens plus 3 threes are 9, so you get 9 ones. Next, you get 10 tens. I have split 12, the number 12, into 10 tens plus 2 tens. If I add 10 plus 2, I get 12. So I split the number 12 into 10 tens plus 2 tens plus the 9 ones which I brought down. Now 10 tens, you know that 10 tens is equal to 100. We have learned this in our large numbers. 10 tens is equal to 100. So 100 plus 2 tens plus 9 ones gives us 129. We get a 3-digit number when we multiply 43 by 3. Let us multiply, take example of a single digit number. Let's take 6 into 7. Now, this is a single digit. 7 is also a single digit. So we are only multiplying the 2 digit. When we multiply 6 into 7, we get the answer 42. When we are asked to write it vertically, then we write 6 into 7 in this form and we get the answer 42. 7, 6 are 42. What we have done is a single digit. We have multiplied two single digits and we have derived the answer as 42. This is very simple, isn't it? If you know your tables well, you can do your multiplication fast. So now, since we have already finished with a single digit, let's take a number, for example, 43 multiplied by 2 digit. Okay, we take, this is a 2 digit, so let us multiply this number with 8. Now we have taken 2 digit number, we are going to multiply by 8. Now this is an example of 2 digit multiplied by 8. So let us write it vertically. We write it this way. Now we have only 2 digit and the number in the 1 space is 8 and the number on top in the 1 space is 3. So 8 threes are, now we have to know what is 8 threes are. We know that 8 threes are is 24. But can we write this 24 down? Because 2 is in the tens place. we cannot write the number 2 down. So we have to carry, we only have to write number 4, which is to your right, below, and take the number 2 and carry it over. What are we doing here is we are carrying over number 2. Why has teacher carried number 2 up? Because 2 is in the tens place and I cannot write it down. So I need to carry it on top. Now I have to multiply the number that is in the tens place. 8 fours are. What is 8 fours are? 8 fours are is 32. Can anyone tell me what is 8 fours are? 8 fours are 32. Now I need to add number 2 to the 32. That means since 8 fours are is 32, I need to add this number 2 to 32. And when I add 32 to 2, I get 34. So my answer now is 344. What has teacher done is, I only multiplied the numbers in the ones and the tens place and I carried the number to the tens place above. I added that digit and I derived the answer as 34. Now 246 multiplied by 5. What is it? This is a 3-digit number multiplied by a single digit, one digit. So what we are going to do is write it vertical. Okay? Write it vertical. So now we take that number 246 and we multiply with the number 5. Now here 5, we take one number in the ones place. This is 6. Please see that you write the numbers neatly. So 5, 6. What is 5, 6? 5, 6 is 30. So we write here 0. We carry the 3 to the tens place. What have we done? Since 5, 6 is 30, I put a 0 down. I carry the number 3 in the tens place. Now 5, 4 is 20. So 20 plus 3, 20 plus 3 gives me 23. Now again I have a 2-digit number. So I am going to write the number 3 which is in the ones place, in the tens place here, and the number in the tens place will go to the hundreds place. I am going to take the number 2 to the hundreds place. Now this is ones, this is ones, this is tens, and this is 100. So what I have done is, I have taken the number 23. 3 I have put down in the tens place and I have carried the 2 in the hundreds place. Now 5 I have to multiply by 200. So 5 twos are is 10 and 10 plus 2 gives me 12. So my answer now is 1230. What is the answer? 1230. This is all that we have multiplied is with a single digit. Take a second example. 54 multiplied by 36. Now this is a horizontal form. When we are going to multiply, to make things easy for you, we have to write it in vertical form. More easy, I will write it here. Because there are two numbers, ones place we have 6 and in the tens place we have 3. So let's take the first number. It's a two-digit multiplication of 2 digits. So 6 fours are 24. Again I need to carry in the tens place. So I put the 2 on near the 10. So 6. Now I go, I have to multiply 6 fives are. I don't take the 3, I only take 6. So 6 fours are 24. I have carried 2 above. Now 6 fives is 30. So 6 fives are 30 plus 2 gives me 32. Now what happens with the next number? I take the 3 and I multiply it with the 4 that is in the 1's place. But I cannot write the answer. Now I get 3 4's as 12. But I cannot write the answer 12 below 4. So what I am going to do is, I am going to write a 0. Or you can write the addition sign. You can either write a 0 or you can write the addition sign. But you cannot write the number below the 1's place. You have to leave it. You have to either write a 0 or a plus sign. You write what you are comfortable with. If you are comfortable with a plus sign, you can write a plus sign or you can write a 0. So we'll take one example with a plus sign, one example with a 0. Okay, 3. Now what we do is, we take 3 which is in the 10's place and multiply by 4. 3 4's are is 12. So I write here 2 and I carry 1 above. Why did I cancel this 2? So that you may not make a mistake. That's why. So I cancel the 2 and I have carried my 1. Because 3 4's are is 12, I carried 1 in the 10's place. Now 3 5's are is 15. So 15 plus my 1 which is on 110 that is up becomes 16. So I write 6 in the 1's place and 1. I take it that 6 goes to the 100's place and 1 goes to the 1000's place. Have you seen? So now what I do is, I put a line because I need to add these numbers. Because addition is repeated multiplication. So I need to add. So 4 plus 0 you know is 4. 2 plus 2 is again 4. What is 6 plus 3? 6 plus 3 gives us 9. And there is no number here. So when there is no number, you have a single digit 1. So the answer to this sum is 1944. But what have we done is, we have multiplied 2 digit by 2 digit. Take 63 multiplied by 72. Let's take 63 multiplied by 72. Here again we write it in the vertical form. Now we take the number that is in the 1's place. 2 3's are is 6. So we write here 6. Now we have to multiply the number in the 10's place. So 2 6 is 12. So what do we have? Do we have to carry over? No. So we write 12. Now here I told you in the 1's place you need to either put a 0 or a plus sign. In our previous sum we put a 0. This time we will put a plus sign. Now take the next number. What is the next number? The next number is 7. What is 7 3's are? Or 3 7's are, for those who don't know your 7 times table, you can say 3 7's are is 21 because 7 3's are is also 21. So 7 3's are 21. This is 2 and 1. 1 is in 1's place, 2 is in 10's place. So I put here 1 and I carry it on top. The number 2 I carry in the 10's place on top of 6. Now 7 6 is again 42. So 42 plus 2 will give me 44. So what do? I write 44. Now I need to add this number. So what is the number now? I get here 6. 1 plus 2 in the 10's place gives me 3 10's. 6 1's, 3 10's. Then I get 4 plus 1, I get 5 hundreds. And I get 4 down, I get 4 thousand. So my answer here is 4,000. 537. Now I will give you some examples of tricks how to multiply in a very short and simple way. This is only to help you to understand the concept. Now I have 23 multiplied by 33. Here I'm going to draw lines. I have number 2, so I will draw 2 lines. I have number 3, I will make 3 lines. This is for you to take a little interest and multiply. Now I have number 3, and so for number 3 I am going to make 3 lines. 1, 2, 3. I have 2, so 2 in the ones place, I am going to make 2 lines. I am going to derive the answer of 23 into 32 by making, now these are vertical lines, have you seen? They are lines of intersection, they are meeting at a point. So I get 1, 2, 3, 4. I get points of intersection. So I first draw all the points of intersection. Alright. And I start counting. Now I have to count from here and then point of intersection in the middle, and then I count the last row. So what I'm going to do is I have to count this. What, how many lines do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points of intersection. So I'm going to write my number 6 here. Now let's do the middle row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So I'm going to write 3 in the 10th space. And I'm going to carry 1 here. I have to count these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What is my answer? My answer is 736. What have I done is I have just drawn lines and the points of intersection. When I add the points of intersection, I get the answer. 736 is same like you would multiply. You're going to do this for your homework and see whether the answer that teacher derived drawing these lines, whether you are able to do the similar way and get the answer as 736. Use the properties of multiplication to fill in the blanks. You're going to use the properties of multiplication which we have already done, and you're going to do this work at home. What you're supposed to do using the properties, 9 into 8 is equal to 8 into 9. I've done the first one. You're going to do the remaining, how the properties are used, the order property, the zero property, and the grouping property, the distributive property. Now complete the table by multiplying the numbers in each column by those in rows. Now here, these are the columns and these are the rows. What you're going to do is, there's a multiplication sign. You are going to multiply from the column into the row. So since this is a column, the column has 2. You have to multiply with the 11. So 2 into 11 gives me 22. Similarly, you need to multiply 3 into 15. When you multiply 3 into 15, you will get 45, because 15 threes are 45. Same way how I showed you to multiply 2-digit numbers by single digit and 2-digit, you can do the same method, multiply in your home rough book and get the answer and fill in the table by multiplying the numbers in each column with the rows. Keep in mind, children, that before you do your multiplication, please visualize how the multiplication is. I have shown you so many tricks how to multiply. So I want you to, rather than just memorizing, please visualize first, because when you visualize the concept, that helps you to remember better. For now, I think you have enjoyed doing multiplication, a part of multiplication. I'll see you in my next class with other concepts in multiplication. Bye for now.